Hi guys, day three. It is hot. It was pretty stagnant all day. This morning something was relatively slow in the same spot, just trying to get eyes on the same on one of those two bucks. I was telling Kaleb we were trying to decide where to go, and you know, we got other places at home on the farm, but there's just nothing that's as intriguing as these two bucks as far as the character they have and the size of them. Plus this farm is one of those funnel farms where you just don't know when they're going to be back, if ever. So you know, the weather's got a little wind finally. It's been 2 days, it's been very stagnant. And again, you know, Kaleb just mentioned the cloud cover, and it's kind of encouraging not to be so hot and so bright so early. So it's just before 5 o'clock now. We kind of got in late just because it's been so hot and miserable. But anyway, switched to our light gear, and again, plan hasn't changed. I get eyes on a buck, but I will say that we've been here, this is our third hunt, and we've yet to see what I would call the same buck as far as being a 3-year-old or older. We did see one that bucked this morning. He was silhouetted over my right shoulder with a doe. I thought he was with that doe. It was a mature buck. It's a little 9-point that we've seen throughout the summer months. And just, you know, a small frame buck, but definitely mature as far as age structure. Other than that, the activity's been very subdued. I talked to the guys, talked to Owen, ran by Kaleb, and these temperatures, you know, are definitely suppressing activity, but again, they're not even acting like they're that frisky. End of the day, we decided that it's October 30th and it's close. It's just, it can trigger at any time. And again, this is our best activity to see a deer that we'd actually want to run an arrow through. So not quite there, but waiting for that cap to bust open. So guys, we're wrapping up here. Last bit of shooting light. It was relatively slow until about, I don't know, about an hour before dark. We caught some movement and saw horns in the CRP to our west, and it was that big old buck, the biggest buck on the farm. He was pushing the doe, dogging her pretty good, kind of pushing her back into that CRP as opposed to coming back into these beams below us. We got some footage of him. We're going to blow it up, see what we can see, make sure that was him. It was kind of a long distance footage, but he got into this bean field on the neighbor that hadn't been cut yet on this tree line, and we can still see him out there. He's kind of back and forth, and a couple other bucks too. He's too far to see. I did try to rattle once I saw him in that field by himself. I think maybe that doe wasn't hot. He was just trying to push her. Maybe she wasn't hot because he was by himself in that field, so we gave a long call sequence, and try to get his attention. It's just too far, and or didn't hear us. We got more interest over there either way. But again, good to get his eyes on him. Again, you know, they are doing their thing. It's probably just been more at night with this, these hotter temps. I'm not sure what the morning holds. At least we know he's in the area, which was wanting to get eyes on the past few days. We finally did. He's better than advertised. The question is, you know, what's he gonna? Is he with that doe? Is that doe hot, or is he still cruising? And you know, again, he's not even on us right now. So is he gonna be around? But in the morning, I feel like if he is around and we can get him on film, then I mean, we can get him maybe called to. Other thing is, we haven't seen him on camera for the past 3 days. So maybe he's been with that doe and now he's coming off of her. I'm not real sure. That's the game we play, and you know, all the things go through your head, and you just hope to make the right move. And it's always struggling with my short vacation time to get up here and get something done in the short window and to be aggressive as I can. But I think it's a deer that he is killable on this farm. It may be later in the year or maybe tomorrow morning. We'll see. But biggest thing is good to see him. Kind of lifts our spirits some, and also he's a tank of a buck. He's got a lot of mass, and he's kind of a tighter buck, but he's got a lot of character, and man, it was good to see him. So mission accomplished somewhat, and let's see if we can finish it out.